The struggle with compulsive porn use is real. I probably don't have to tell you that. If you're experiencing brain fog, low motivation, and especially erectile dysfunction, a form of sexual arousal dysfunction that I call SAD, I don't have to tell you the struggle is real. But if you want to feel better, if you want to be able to concentrate, you want to feel motivated, and you want to get back to business in your real life, then in this video, I'm going to share with you the neuroscience behind compulsive porn use, and more importantly, what you can do to leave the screen. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. Welcome back to the channel. I'm on a mission to help as many people as possible leave explicit matter behind because it's damaging their brains. And I want you to get back on purpose in your life. If that's what you're looking for and you want the science behind it, then you're in the right place. Let's get started. Why is porn more addictive than ever? Well, they call it the three A's. It's accessible, affordable, and anonymous. It makes it very dangerous. And of course, porn in your pocket. Even children have phones. So if you become exposed to porn and then your brain needs that rush, it's so easy for you to go back. This hijacks your brain. That rush, that good feeling that you feel in your brain is actually the seeds of addiction. Back in the 70s, there was a doctor. His name was Dr. Feelgood. If you know the Motley Crue song, he's the one they called Dr. Feelgood. Well, what you know is that Dr. Feelgood was actually harming all the celebrities that he worked with. He said he was giving them vitamin shots. Not vitamin shots, indeed. Well, unfortunately, porn's the same way. Many people think they're using porn to relax and that it's a harmless habit and that it helps you sleep. Maybe you think it's improving your sexual performance. Well, science shows the opposite. Science shows that not only is it giving you erectile dysfunction, it's also tanking your sexual satisfaction. It makes you less attracted to your partner, and it actually gives you body image issues yourself. So, not feel good at all. There's a scientific law called Hebb's Law. Hebb's Law says that neurons that fire together wire together. This is the essence of neuroplasticity. But guess what? Neuroplasticity, it goes in the direction that you push it. It doesn't discern for itself. So if you keep going back to porn, you keep wiring in those neurons and those neural pathways that will keep you going back for more and more and more. That's the essence of dopamine. Those neural pathways become so ingrained that it can be very difficult for you to leave porn behind. I probably don't have to tell you that. It leads to hypersexuality. That means your brain is looking for dopamine hits all over the place. I always say that knowledge is power. I write about it in the introduction of my new book, Mind Over Explicit Matter. Once you know that porn's hijacking your brain and it's neurochemically making you go back for more, now you are empowered to create new neural pathways, create those pleasure pathways back into your life. But you need a plan. You might think porn is your Dr. Feelgood, but what you might not realize is that you're not connecting the dots between your porn use and the mental and physical health issues that you've been struggling with for a long time. So science shows that porn causes anxiety, depression, erectile dysfunction, low motivation, porn-induced ADHD. It can make it so that it's so difficult for you to perform well in your life. At the same time, you stop enjoying your life. The work that used to fire you up, you don't find engaging anymore. That partner that you used to love to be with, it doesn't do it for you anymore. Maybe you've even decided to stop going out with your friends because it's not that fun. Guess what? All those things are actually amazing. The hijacking in your brain has linked you to pleasure from porn. What that means is that the pleasure everywhere else has decreased. Well, I want you to have a brain hack strategy. So right now, in your pleather journal or in your phone, list out all the mental and physical health issues that you're struggling with. If it has to do with focus, if it has to do with feeling calm, if it has to do with feeling connected to people in the world, I want you to know, if you consume porn, it's a variable. So list them out, and then we'll keep connecting the dots together. Okay, so I know all that probably sounds really overwhelming, but remember, neuroplasticity, Hebb's law, neurons that fire together, wire together, they can be changed. We know that the brain is pliable, it's moldable like Play-Doh, and you're the creator. So you have the opportunity right now to start molding your brain, but it means you have to make a digital detox plan. You have to stay away from explicit matter. Every time you go back for more, you're firing up those neural pathways. Instead, I want you to make a plan that you're creating and then reinforcing the neural pathways back into healthy real-world pleasure. So make a plan. What are you going to do to get real-world pleasure? I'll tell you what I'm doing. Thankfully, I'm hitting the beach. I need a break 9 out of 10 bad. So the hubs and my youngest daughter, we're going to the beach. And you know what we're going to do? We're going to do nothing. We're going to chill. I'm probably going to get burnt to a crisp because my teenage daughter has already informed me we'll be spending 7 hours laying out. So if in the next video I'm burnt red, you know why. But I will be enjoying real world pleasure. Beach walks and runs, breathing in the ionized salt air, just taking a couple days to relax and to enjoy the people around me. This is real world pleasure. And if you're missing out on that, it's time for you to make the plan to get back to business. So if you need help, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. You can download the free guide that I've created, 32 brain hacks to help you reclaim your life and to reclaim the pleasure that used to be there for you. If you're serious about doubling down on recovery and rewiring your brain quickly and effortlessly, then reach out to my team, call or text them. They can help you move forward so that we can help you by evaluating your brain in a qEEG brain map. They're totally awesome. Every person who gets one values being able to see the brain dysfunction that has happened due to porn use. But more importantly, that brain map is the map. It's the map that shows what your brain needs to heal. From there, I set very specific brain training neurofeedback protocols just for you. This way, your brain can rewire and hardwire in those neural pathways so that you can have long-lasting success. So if you need help, please visit drtrishleigh.com. Put a red X in the comments so that you're committing to quit. And write me a comment. I read every single one of them. Then click the video in the corner that comes up. There's more brain hacks coming your way. And this way, we can stay on the journey together. I got you. All right, so remember, as always, control your brain or it will control you.